congratulations for Minari.
Thank you, Guy.
So what attracted you to a project like Minari for yourself?
처음에 대본을 받았을 때는 사실 아직 미나리, 모니카에 대해서 잘 파악이 안 됐어요. 근데 감독님을 보고 나서 아 정말 너무 좋은 사람이구나, 이 사람하고는 무조건 해야겠다라는 생각이 들었고, 뭔가 아이작과 함께 모니카를 만드는 그 과정이 되게 재밌을 것 같았어요.
When I first received the script, there were a lot of gaps in her character and I wasn't sure how I'm going to portray it. It was after meeting Isaac that I wanted to do this film because he's genuinely such a great person and I wanted to work with him on building Monica's character.
Was it a relief that you didn't have to speak English in this film and it was all Korean for you?
Yeah. 당연히 사실은 처음 영어 스크립으로 받았을 때, 잉글리시 스크립으로 받았을 때는 영어를 준비해야겠다, 그리고 내가 할 수 있는 한 많이 준비해서 가야겠다라는 생각을 했었는데, 감독님이 한국어로 찍고 싶다고 하시는 거예요. 그래서 우와 너무 좋은데 라는 생각을 했고, 왜냐하면 그만큼 풍부하게 모니카를 더 많이 표현할 수 있을 거라고 생각을 했기 때문에, 그리고 가장 제가 생각했을 때 영화 안에서 모니카가 가장 한국적인 그런 정서를 많이 가지고 있는 사람이었거든요.
Oh, absolutely. When I first received the script, the English version, I felt I had to prepare myself. I thought I would prepare as much as I can in terms of speaking English in the film. But when I met with Isaac, he said, I wanted Monica's character to speak Korean. So I was ecstatic. The reason was that way I'll be able to more fully and more richly express the character. And I believe she is one of the most Korean character in the film too.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Does this movie, Minari, feel more like a Korean movie to you or feels like an American movie to you?
저한테는 확실히 한국 영화처럼 느껴지고요. 이게 어찌 되었건 굉장히 한국적인 정서와 그리고 이야기들이라고 생각이 되었고, 제가 그렇게 생각했기 때문에 사실은 더 풍부하게 모니카를 표현할 수 있었던 것 같아요. 만약에 이게 미국 이야기고 나는 미국에서 지금 지내니까 모니카를 조금 더 미국인들이 이해하게 연기해야지라고 했으면은 지금처럼 못하지 않았을까라는 생각이 들어요.
To me, definitely, it felt like a Korean film. In any case, it deals with Korean emotions and Korean story. And because I thought that way, I was able to portray the character as it was, with full and rich character. If I thought it was an American story and I had to comprehend, I had to somehow convey that for the American audience, then that version of Monica would be quite different.
그게 아마 이민 1세대들이 갖는 그 이민 2세대와의 큰 차이점이라는 생각도 들고, 이 사람들은 확실히 많은 시행착오와 그리고 소통의 어려움을 겪고 있다고 생각을 하고 있고요. 모니카도 그 중심에 있는 사람이라고 생각했기 때문에 더 한국적으로 보였을 것 같아요.
Monica's character was definitely a person who can be categorized as the first generation immigrant as opposed to second generation. They are the people who experienced that trial and error firsthand and difficulty of communication firsthand.
Yeah.
Now, since you experience an American production now, was there a major difference between American production and Korean production? And how did you like it?
일단 굉장히 스몰 버전이어가지고 큰 차이를 느끼지는 못했어요. 그냥 영어로 소통해야 된다라는 점, 그 점이 가장 저한테는 크게 왔고.
Because it was a small budget film, I didn't feel a big difference compared to other Korean films that I've done. The only noticeable difference was that English was spoken on the set.
그래서 이제 헐리우드에서 온 스태프들이 예리 앞으로 계속 할리우드에서 영화 찍었으면 좋겠어. 모든 현장이 이런 건 아니고 우리가 조금 힘들긴 했어. 뭐 이렇게 얘기를 해서 저한테 계속 keep going 하라고 얘기했었어요.
I guess that's why a lot of the crew on the set told me that, oh, this isn't what the typical Hollywood set is like, or the typical American filmmaking environment is like. So you should continue making more films.
I'm curious. Did they have you eat a lot of Korean food or American food on set?
그때 선생님과 저를 캐스팅하게 도와준 이인아라는 굉장히 좋은 사람이 있어요. 그 사람이 철사에서 촬영하는 게 굉장히 힘들 테니 본인이 도와주겠다. 우선 선생님과 저랑 에어비앤비에서 지냈었는데 그때 와서 정말 한국 음식을 너무 많이 해줘서 40도가 넘는 현장에서 버틸 수 있었던 것
There's this wonderful person called Ina Lee who helped me and Yeojung join this project, be part of this project. She was worried that while we film in Tulsa, we were staying at an Airbnb, and she wanted to make sure that we were in good health to pull ourselves through the production. So she would come and cook us a lot of Korean food, and I think it really did help us get through that 104 degree heat.
I love the chemistry between you and Steven. Could you talk about the preparation between you two? Because I could feel the power of parents arguing through that.
사실 그 에어비앤비가 약간 정말 아지트처럼 됐었거든요. 그래서 매일 영화에 대해서 얘기하고, 그리고 스티븐과 저 같은 경우는 계속 신발 씬을 계속했어요. 그리고 왜 함께 하는 걸까? 왜 우리가 서로를 구원하려고 했었던 것일까에 대한 얘기들을 정말 엄청 많이 했던 것 같아요. 그리고 제 고백 꿈, 모니카의 꿈 이런 것들을 끊임없이 얘기하면서 현장까지 갔던 것 같아요. 촬영까지.
That Airbnb I was staying was like the meeting place for all of us. We would talk about the film every day. We'll meet up there and talk about the film every day. And especially Stephen and I would constantly go through scene by scene all of our scenes together. And we talked about why are they together and why are they trying to constantly save each other. What are the aspirations of Jacob? What are dreams of Monica? We had a constant conversation about these.
Excellent. Well, hey, thank you very much. I really appreciate this. Thank you.